Welcome to the video tutorial of deploying an OpenAI instance on CentOS 7 operating system using Docker and Docker Compose. Some steps in this installation require root-level privileges to the system where OpenAI will be deployed, but we allow as a root for whole installation process. First step of preparing the system is configuring persistent settings for Elasticsearch, also disabling IPv6 to prevent any potential network issues. We run command sysctl-p to apply the setting without restarting the system. Now we are going to install Docker. Firstly, we install required packages. Then we set up stable repository. Install Docker Community Edition. Now we start and enable Docker to start it automatically on boot and avoid having to start Docker every time before running Docker commands. To verify that Docker was installed correctly, on our system, we run the Hello World image. Here we can see the Docker is fine, and now we can move to Docker Compose. This deployment requires installing Docker Compose. We can get the latest version of Docker Compose from GitHub repository and then apply execute permissions to the binary. Now let's check versions of installed Docker and Docker Compose. To clone OpenAI Docker Compose project from GitHub, we have to install Git tool. Now we can clone repository from GitHub. Let's see what this repository. There are two folders, 3.0 and 3.0.2. These are supported versions of Docker Community Edition. Also, YAML configuration files are included in these folders. Following scripts are included in the folder for deploying an OpenAI instance. env.sh, file containing environment variables. setup.sh, script for setting up and updating an OpenAI configuration. startup.sh, script for starting up the OpenAI instance. shutdown.sh, script for shutting down all OpenAI stacks except volumes. And tear.sh, script for tearing down all OpenAI stacks, volumes, and networks. Once we clone project, we are in master branch. Let's switch it to our release branch. It's time to edit script env.sh. We should point version of Docker Compose. Then check that OpenAI version number match selected earlier git branch. And set up variable OpenAI rproxy HTTP. We set it to 1 since we don't want to configure HTTPS now. The swarm mode is enabled by initializing a swarm. Let's make sure that we initialize the Docker swarm. Fine. Let's log in with our Docker ID to pull the images from the OpenAM Docker repository. Now we can run setup.sh. The setup script sets environment variables, initializes the network, and pulls OpenAM images from the Docker repository. The terminal outputs information about the setup progress. Let's verify that the OpenAM images were pulled successfully by typing the following command and viewing the output. We have all needed images in place and we can run startup script. The terminal outputs information about the starting up progress. Command watch will help us to keep an eye on startup progress in real time. Here we can see a list of containers, images, names, and their status. When all containers become healthy, it means that OpenAM is up and running. If all containers brought up and have status healthy, we can type a following curl command in the terminal to confirm that backend is running. The return value of this curl command should contain HTTP 200 OK if the system is running successfully. Now we can access the web application in browser. We are using IP address of virtual machine. We are logging as sysadmin and we have to change the password since this is first time logging. Then we have to answer security questions. Now we set up content provider. Please pay attention to application servers. For Docker installations, you have to use this URL. Fine, we are done. Now we are in web console. Application is ready to use. To get to self-service portal, we have to change URL in browser. Thanks for attention.